Hello students, today we are going to start our new chapter of class 8, that is force and pressure. Students, in class 7th even you have studied about speed, uniform motion, non-uniform motion, distance and all other parameters, right? So here you can see in the slide a car is moving on the road, a boat is moving in the sea and the car is moving on the road, right? Have you ever thought what is the cause behind motion of these objects? How is the car able to move forward? Or how is the boat able to move in the water? What makes the bullock cart be in motion? The answer to all these questions is the physical quantity called force. Now what is force? A force is a push or pull on any object to produce visible changes in the speed or shape is called force. So what do you understand with this? A force. Force is a push or pull, means whenever you are pushing something, you know, you are applying your power to push it, or you are pulling something, you are applying your full strength to pull it even, right? This push or pull, or this the power you are applying to push or pull, that is called force. The force, you know, cause lots of various changes, lots of changes even, like changing the speed, shape and all. And the SI units for the force is Newton, means force is measured in Newtons. Means a car is able to move because its engine gives some kind of force which move it forward. A sailboat moves forward due to the force applied by the wind. A bullock cart moves because a force is applied by oxen to make it forward. Oxen muscles, you know, apply lots of force on the floor which able to move it forward. These examples mainly feature force producing some kind of motion even. Okay students, so even here you can see in the picture a boy is, you know, exerts a pull on the rope. He is pulling the board towards himself, right? In the second picture, boy exerts a push on the board. He is pushing the board, means applying force towards the water to push the board in the water. Right students? Here you can see in the next slide even, you know, a goalkeeper keep saving a goal, applying force with the hands to stop the ball. In the second B figure, you can see a hockey player, you know, flicking a ball by applying the force with the hands to the hockey to flick the ball, right? And in the third case, a fielder stopping the ball by applying hand with the force. Okay students, so these are the some examples for the force, or the where the forces need to be at. So the next is, forces are due to interaction. So what do you understand with this? Forces are due to interaction. It means at least two objects must interact with each other for a force to come into play. Means to for the force, we need at least two objects to interact with each other. Okay, for example, you can see here, suppose a man is, you know, standing behind a stationary car. Do you think the car will move due to his presence only? No. You can see in the second picture, you know, the boy is pushing the car. Will the car move? Yes, the car will move in the direction of the applied force. You can see the man has to push the car to make it move. Means there is an interaction between the car and the man. His hand touching the car means two objects are interacting with each other to, you know, to the force to be act. Okay students, in the next picture you can see a man is pulling the cow, right? And cow is pulling the man towards herself, right? So there is an interaction between the two. They both are trying to pull each other. So from this we can conclude, without an interaction the force cannot be applied to change its state, right? The interaction may be either by our efforts or by the object in contact. Hope you get it students. Students, as we know, in real life situation, more than one force can act on object, right? If you are not able to, you know, move the box alone, you know two persons apply the force to move the box, right? So what happened when more than one force act on object? For this we are having a few formulas. Let's discuss about that. So in the first case, when two forces, that is F1 and F2, are applied in the same direction, mean two boys are applying force in the same direction, then the total force acting acting is the sum of two individual forces, means to the force of two boys will be addition of the two boys forces will be there, means if one boy is applying 40 newton, okay, and the second boy is applying 20 newton, and the total will be the sum of the two boys forces, like F1 and F2, 40 plus 20 means total force applied is 16 newton, means when two persons are applying force from the same direction, there will be addition of their forces, and the object moves in the direction of F1 and F2. So students, in the second case, when two forces F1 and F2 are applied in the opposite direction, means one is applying from the right side and other is applying from the left side, means two opposite forces are acting, then the total force will be the difference between the two individual forces. Means if from the left side boy is applying 60 newton force and from the right side a boy is applying 40 newton force, then the total force will be the difference between the two, means it will be 60 minus 40, then the total force will be 20 newton, means total force applying on the box is 20 newton. Even under this we are having two cases, when F1 is greater than F2, as in the case we can see, as I have discussed with the NAS numerical, I said that the left side boy applied 60 newton and the right side boy applied 40 newton, means F1 was 60 and F2 was 40, then the total force will be F1 minus F2, 60 minus 40, and then the total force was 20 newton, right? So then the object will move in the direction of F1, because F1 is applying larger force, then the object will move in the direction of F1. Okay students, so in under this we are having another case, like when F2 is greater than F1, for example we can say, like from the F1 is applying 40 newton and F2 is applying 60 newton, then the total force will be F2 minus F1, means 60 minus 40, then the total force will be 20 newton, and the object will move in the direction of F2, because F2 is applying in this case the larger force. Okay students, now the third case is, if F1 and F2 are applying equal forces, means from the right side even the boy is applying 20 newton and from the left side even the boy is applying 20 newton, then what happens, according to you what happens? The object will not move, the object will be still, and such forces are said to be balanced forces, because the object is still, it cannot move because 20 newton is applying from the right side and 20 newton is applied from the left side, so the object remains still. Okay students, hope you get it. For example, have you seen a game of tug of war, right? In this game, two teams pulls a rope in the opposite direction. Member of both the team tries to, you know, pull the rope in their own direction. The team which applied the larger force wins at the end, right? And when two teams, you know, pulls the rope equally, means with the equal force, then the rope does not move, it remains still. Okay students, so now we will study about the various effects of force or the various changes. So first is, force can cause motion in a stationary object, or you can say change in motion. For example, a book is lying on a table. Students, if a book is lying on a table, it cannot move until you are applying force in it. Have you ever observed that there is a book lying on the table and itself move from one direction to other direction? No. It will not move unless we are applying force. We are pushing it or pulling it to move from one place to another. Similarly, you know, you can see in the picture here, a boy is, you know, pushing the cupboard to move it from one place to another. Have you ever observed Almira moves itself from one place to another? No, it doesn't move unless the force is applied on it. In the third picture, even you can say, you know, a woman is applying force to the child pram, right? When she applies the force, it changes its direction or it moves in the direction of the applied force. In each case, you move an object at rest by applying force only. Force can cause motion in a stationary object, but it is not necessary every time. You can't move a, you know, wall, standing wall that you applying forces and it's moving. It never happens, right? So when you are trying to push a tree in your garden, it will not move. The reason is that force applied by you is not sufficient to move the wall or a tree. Okay, students? So next is, force can stop a moving object. Like when a football player kicks the football towards the goal, the goalkeeper applies force to stop the ball. Right, students? When ball, you know, comes to the goalkeeper applies hand with his force, the hands, right, to stop the ball. Similarly, when you apply brakes, the bicycle stops. A moving ball can stop even on its own due to the presence of friction. A moving ball can stop, come to rest when we apply force with your hand, right? So these are the some examples that force can stop a moving object even. Next is, the force can change the direction of motion even. When a batman hit the ball with its bat, the direction of the moving ball changes, right? It deflects from its direction. Similarly, when a player kicks the football, it deflects from its direction, right? When, you know, in the game of snooker, when cue ball is hit, it gets into motion and hits other balls, changing their direction. Means when the cue ball hit the ball, all the, you know, balls change its direction of motion, or they deflect from their path. So these are the some examples for change in the direction. So next is, the change in the speed. Force can change the speed of a moving object. When a person pushes a moving swing, it moves faster, and when he pulls the swing in the opposite direction, it slows down, right? Similarly, when force is applied on the pedal by a cyclist, the speed of the cycle increases, right? So force can change the speed of the object even. Students, when you roll a ball on a level surface and you keep your, you know, palm between the way when it's moving, what happens to the ball? Is it stops or its speed increase or decrease? Here I'll explain. If the force applied on the object is in the direction of its motion, means if we apply like it's moving from east to west and we are applying the force from the east only, then its speed will increase because it's already coming from east to west, means its direction is from east to west. If we apply force even from the east direction, it moves in the faster speed. And if the force is applied in the direction opposite to the direction of motion, like if I apply force from the west side, then it will result in the decrease in the speed of object, right? Because we are applying an opposite force, and due to the opposite force, the speed of the ball decreases. There are so many other examples, like sometimes the ball returns to the other side of the court by pushing or smashing it, right? In the cricket, batsman plays or hits her shot by applying a force on the ball with the bat even, right? So many examples are here, students. So next, the state of motion. What is the state of motion? The state of motion on an object is described its speed and the direction of motion. A state of rest is considered to be the state of zero speed. Means state of rest, which is a state of rest when the speed is zero. Okay, an object may be at rest or in motion. Both are the states of motion. Means the object is in the rest condition. We can't say it's not in motion. Both are the motion states, whether it is in rest or whether it is in motion. Now next is the change in shape. Like when you knead the floor, it changes its shape into the dough. And dough can again, we can change its shape with the roller to make chapatis. So it can even change its shape and size. It's due to the only the force applied. Next is the when you you know stretch the rubber band. When you stretch the rubber band changes its shape and size. Next is when you squeeze the lemon. The when it extracted its all juice and all, then it changes its shape, right? So these are the various changes by in which the force can change the shape and size of the object. So students, these are the various changes that caused by the force. So we conclude a force make a object